Hello, everyone. I'm Dr. Gary Kraus, neurosurgeon and founder of the Kraus TBI Institute in Houston, Texas. I'm also author of the recently published textbook, Traumatic Brain Injury, A Neurosurgeon's Perspective. This work encompasses a comprehensive review and overview of traumatic brain injuries, some of which we'll touch upon in today's discussion. A previous book which I'd written, Microsurgical Anatomy of the Brain, A Stereo Atlas, covers the neurosurgical anatomy of the brain, which is crucial for every neurosurgeon. Understanding the anatomy and function of the brain is important for us to gain an understanding of traumatic brain injury. Now, in my recent book, Traumatic Brain Injury, A Neurosurgeon's Perspective, I dive deep into various aspects of traumatic brain injuries, sharing insights from my years of experience in this field. It's designed to be accessible to both medical professionals as well as anyone interested in understanding the complexity of the brain and the impact of injuries on the brain. And welcome to this journey, which we're going to go on together today, into the fascinating world of the human brain, particularly the frontal lobes. Our brain is an intricate masterpiece, and understanding its workings is critical and pivotal to decoding human cognition and human behavior. Today, together, we'll delve into the intricacies of the frontal lobes, the control center of our brain, and uncover how they shape our thoughts, our emotions, and our actions. We'll also explore the historical context of our knowledge of the frontal lobes and shed light on how our understanding has evolved over time and its significance in developing therapeutic interventions for neurological and psychiatric disorders. So let's sit back, relax, and together, let's embark on an enlightening journey. And remember, the more we understand about our brain, the better we can take care of it, ultimately leading to a healthier and more fulfilling life. Are you on a quest to master your mind? As we embark on an enthralling journey into the wonders of the frontal lobes, we learn about the control center of our brains, and we uncover how they shape our thoughts, emotions, and our actions. Decoding the intricacies of the frontal lobes is pivotal to understanding human cognition and human behavior. Now, imagine this. Situated behind our forehead is one of the most advanced and refined parts of our brain, the frontal lobes. This portion, the frontal lobes, is instrumental in making you distinctively you. From intricate thinking, strategizing, and reasoning to personality molding, the frontal lobes serve as the control hub for many of the unique mental abilities that differentiate us from other species. Let's demystify the frontal lobes. The frontal lobes are composed of several pivotal structures, each of which has functions which help us with specific roles. Number one, the prefrontal cortex, the command center of our brain, managing executive functions like strategizing, organizing, decision-making, and problem-solving. It also oversees attention, impulse restraint, as well as working memory. Number two, the motor cortex, the orchestrator of voluntary movements, directing fine motor skills and coordination. Number three, Broca's area, the language maestro, accountable for speech production and articulation. Number four, the orbito-frontal cortex, the decision-making center, engaged in emotional regulation, reward processing, and assessing potential outcomes and repercussions of actions. Number five, the frontal eye fields. The director of visual attention, directing voluntary eye movements, and tracking moving objects. Number six, personality and social behavior. Influencing facets of personality, behavior, and social cognition. Damage in this region can result in personality alterations, impulsivity, emotional regulation issues, and socially inappropriate behaviors. And number seven, working memory. The mental scratch pad, vital for intricate cognitive tasks, as well as multitasking and problem solving. The frontal lobes are also central to executive function. And by that, I mean a collection of mental processes which are needed for goal-oriented behavior, attention regulation, inhibition, working memory, and cognitive flexibility. Essentially, it acts as your brain's management system, or CEO, vital for success in both personal and professional spheres. In addition, the frontal lobes are key to social interactions and emotional regulation. Difficulties or dysfunction in this region can lead to emotional instability, impulsiveness, and a lack of behavioral control. Additionally, various subregions within the frontal lobes contribute to different aspects of personality, such as extroversion, introversion, agreeableness, and conscientiousness. Damage or dysfunction in these areas can lead to significant personality changes, resulting in traits that are incongruous and inconsistent with one's previous self. In addition, disruptions in the frontal lobe's extensive connectivity can contribute to a range of neurological and psychiatric disorders, including the following: ADHD, autism spectrum disorders, schizophrenia, and depression. So, how does damage or dysfunction in the frontal lobes impact an individual's ability to plan and make decisions? It can result in impaired judgment, difficulty planning, lack of initiative, impulsivity, poor self-control, limited problem-solving skills, and challenges in social and emotional decision-making. Symptoms which are commonly seen after frontal lobe damage include impaired judgment, lack of insight, impulsivity, poor problem solving, inflexibility and perseveration, reduced ability to anticipate outcomes, and difficulty with multitasking, as well as emotional and behavioral changes. So, to summarize, the frontal lobes are a crucial region of the human brain, responsible for numerous cognitive functions and higher level thinking. Understanding their functions and importance can illuminate neurological and psychiatric disorders and contribute to developing therapeutic interventions targeting these specific regions. Let's discuss a bit of history and put this into context. How did we learn about the importance of the frontal lobes and about their function? Since we've talked about the significance of the frontal lobes in decision-making, personality, and social interactions, we're going to take a slight historical detour and explore the remarkable and captivating story of Mr. Phineas Gage. This is a narrative that underscores the frontal lobe's crucial role in shaping our personality and our behavior. In 1848, Mr. Phineas Gage was a railroad construction foreman, and he suffered a life-changing injury. While compressing explosive powder into a hole using a tamping iron, the powder inadvertently detonated, propelling the iron rod through the left frontal portion of his skull. Remarkably, Mr. Gage survived the incident, but the iron rod destroyed much of his left frontal lobe. Now, here's the remarkable and intriguing part. Before the injury, Mr. Gage was described as a well-mannered, responsible, and socially skilled individual. After the injury, his personality underwent a dramatic transformation. He became impulsive, irritable, and socially inappropriate, exhibiting traits that were completely incongruous and inconsistent with his former self before the injury. This dramatic change in personality highlighted the essential role of the frontal lobes in shaping our personality and our social behavior. Now, Gage's case was one of the first to suggest a direct link between traumatic brain injury or brain damage, specifically in the frontal lobes, and changes in personality and behavior. His story provided early evidence of the frontal lobes' important functions and laid the foundation for further research into the brain's intricacies. To this day, Phineas Gage's story continues to resonate with neuroscientists, psychologists, and the general public. It serves as a poignant reminder of the delicate interplay between our brain, personality, and social interactions. So the next time you find yourself making a decision or reacting in a social situation, remember Phineas Gage's tale and the critical role your frontal lobes play in shaping who you are. Let's go back for a moment to the overall importance of the frontal lobes. Understanding their functions and significance can shed light on neurological and psychiatric disorders and aid in the development of therapeutic interventions targeting these specific regions of the brain. As we continue to unravel the complexities of the frontal lobes, we gain deeper insights into the nature of human cognition and behavior. So again, the next time you make a decision, remember, your frontal lobes are hard at work. If you found this video insightful, please hit the like button, subscribe to the channel, and share your thoughts in the comments below. Your engagement helps us to create more content that empowers and educates. Thanks for watching.